Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today, we are going to give an introduction to Microsoft Project so that you can get an idea of how to start building a project management file inside of Microsoft Project. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. First, I would like to go over how you can download Microsoft Project. I will include this link in the description below. But for the purposes of today, we are going to use Project Plan 3 right here, the middle option, because that gives us an online version and also a version that we can use on our desktop. So how do I start Microsoft Project? Well, there's a couple of different ways once you have installed it. I can go down here to the Start button and just scroll down to Project, or I can type in the search box and just type Project and launch the app from here. So once I'm inside Microsoft Project, I have a couple of different options here. If I go to New, I have a bunch of different templates down here that I can use depending on what kind of project I'm planning on working on. But for purposes of today, since it's an overview, I'm just going to go to Blank Project. And once I hit Blank Project, this is the default screen that will appear. So let's think, what kind of project could I be working on? I could work on anything from an in-depth business project to planning a party. And since it's graduation season, I thought maybe we would put in a few steps to plan a graduation party. And then hopefully you can expand this idea to more large-scale projects that you may have. So the first thing I want to do is just click on this task name and list out some of the tasks I may have for my graduation party. So first I'm going to put send invitations. And then I'm going to put buy food, buy decorations, cook food, decorate. And then I'll put party at the end, since that is the end of the project that we are planning right now. And I'm just going to update some of these names of my tasks so they reflect a little bit more of the action that I'm going to take for each of them. So how long will it take me to send invitations? For now, I'm going to estimate that that might take 1 hour. So I'm just going to put in a 1 and then an H for hour. And then I'm going to pick a start date for that. So let's say I would like to send invitations out on the 22nd. But how about my party? Let's say my party is going to be on Saturday the 28th. And I can put a duration in for that too. And I'm just going to type 5H. You can see that the finish date is automatically calculated based on my start time and how many hours. So let's say shopping for food is going to take me about 4 hours. And let's say I want to do that 2 days before the party happens. And let's say I'd like to shop for decorations, and that's going to take about 2 hours. And I could do that on the Wednesday before the party. And then let's say cooking food is going to take me about 5 hours, and I want to do that the night before the party. And let's say decorating and setup is going to take another 2 hours. And I could do that 2 days before the party. So I've now entered in my big tasks for what I need to do to plan this party. And if you look over here, you will see that there have been some boxes created. And these boxes represent the day that the task needs to be done on, as well as how long that task is going to take. And you can notice right here that my boxes are only within 1 week. So if I want to zoom in on what this view would look like, I can just double click up here on the date. And instead of having units set for weeks, I can change that to days. So I can zoom in a little bit more on when my project is really taking place. So I'm going to click OK. And you can see that my boxes have gotten a little bit bigger. And I can also quickly see from this Gantt chart that my Thursday is going to be my busiest day. So if I don't want to get really stressed out during this party planning, I can look at both of my tasks that are taking place on Thursday. I have shop for food, and I also have decorate and setup. So if I feel like that's going to be a really stressful day, I could rethink some of my strategy right here. So if I look at Wednesday, I'm planning on shopping for decorations, but I don't have anything going on Monday or Tuesday, so I could just click this and drag it over here to have it happen on the previous day. And if you look over here for shop for decorations, you can see that that date has now been updated to Tuesday. And then I could take this bar right here representing my decorating, and I could just drag this over to Wednesday. And now it seems like my time is a little more spaced out here. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So let's think about some of these tasks a little bit more. I can't really decorate until I shop for decorations. So if I double click on Decorate and Setup, I can click on this tab right here called Predecessors. And if I click in Task Name and hit this drop down, I can look at some of my tasks that I've already entered, and I can set one of these tasks to have to happen before this task. So in this case, I would need to shop for decorations before I can decorate. So I'm going to click on that and say OK. And when I do that, a couple of things have changed on the screen. Under Predecessors, you can see that a 3 has been put in there. And that 3 corresponds with this 3 up here, shop for decorations. And if you look over here on the Gantt chart, you can see this arrow that indicates that this task has to happen before this task. Now, I would like to set this back to happening on Wednesday so that I only have one task per day. And you can see that the arrow has moved there too. But there's another task here that has to happen before the other, and that would be cook food. I would need to shop for the food before I cooked it. So I'm going to double-click on cook food, go to the task, and change that to shop for food and say OK. So now let's see what will happen if I try to move a task before its predecessor. So let's take this one right here, decorate and set up. I'm going to click on that and drag to the left. So you can see that this box now has a dotted rectangle around it. And that dotted rectangle means that there's a conflict in my schedule because I can't start decorating before I have the decorations. So in order to fix that, I'm just going to click on that task and drag it back to Wednesday. And now I have no errors in my schedule. I can also double-click on my task here, and I can change the color for this task. So say I want anything shopping related to be in orange. And say OK. So I can quickly look here and say, oh, those are shopping related tasks. And so maybe I could think about overlapping those tasks somehow. But if I do that, I'm going to have a lot of stress in the end of my week because I need to shop for decorations before I decorate, and I need to shop for food before I cook. And so shopping together might not be the best idea right here because I don't want to buy food too early because I don't want it to go bad. So I'm going to just leave things the way that they are. So now I would like to look at my cook food task right here. I'm not being very specific here, but if I wanted to get more specific on what kind of food I was going to cook, and I can click on cook food, and above that, I'm going to put in summary. So I'm going to right-click here and go to insert task a couple times. And for this task, I'm going to highlight and say bake cake. And that's going to take me about 1 hour. And let's do that on Friday. You can also click here and say prep salads, and let's say that will take another hour on Friday. And then after this one, we can say prep sides, and let's say that takes an hour on Friday. And finally, let's change this one to prep appetizers, and let's say that's going to take 2 hours on Friday. So now what you can see over here is this bracket has been placed. And what this bracket means is that this main task is made up of these subtasks that are underneath. So if I were to drag any of these tasks over to another day, you can see that my summary is widened to compensate for that subtask under that main task. But I'm going to hit Control Z to go back to the way that we had it before. And I'm also going to go up here and change this duration to 5 hours because that's what all of my subtasks add up to. Now, if I had a task on here that I no longer needed to do, I could highlight the row and right-click and go to Delete Task. But I would have to go back here and update this manually to 4 hours. I can also double-click here for this task, and I can click on this Notes tab, and I can add any notes in here that I would like. See Outlook list of names. And I can say OK. And now this little icon right here appears, letting me know that I have some notes for that task. And it also gives me a preview of what those notes are if I just hover over it. If one of these tasks is going to take longer than I originally thought it was, say I run out of ink on my printer and I'm having trouble printing invitations, I can click on here and I can hover the mouse until it looks like an arrow pointing to the right, hold my mouse button down and drag and make that time a lot longer. If I were to do the same over here for the summary task, you can see that I'm going to get an error because that summary task has exceeded the time that I have set for the duration for the main task. So if I went up here and I changed this to 8 hours, you can see that that error has gone away. If I have a dependency on here that I no longer want, I can just go over here to predecessors and delete that predecessor. And you can see that that arrow will go away. I can also highlight a task and go up here to inactivate. And it will keep my task on this list in case I need to come back to it later, but it will cross it out here and make the box on the Gantt chart a white box to indicate an inactive task. So if I highlight that task again, I can click the inactivate button and it will be reactivated. So finally, if I go to File, Save As, I can browse and you will see that my project file will be saved as a .mpp because that's the file type for Microsoft Project. So I'm just going to give that a name and hit save. So hopefully this has given you a really quick introduction to how you can manage a simple project inside of Microsoft Project. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you soon. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.